putting my arm in the way, but you know, that's how it is sometimes. I'm gonna go ahead and take a bite there for you guys. Homemade.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Snoopy East4way back in the house again with another mukbang, collab. And this collab is with the homeboy Trejo's World, alright? Now, this brother right here is hella cool and funny as hell, so y'all already know the drill. You go over there, you show him some love, you tell him Snoopy East sent you, alright? Check out his videos. You know, if you're sitting down, you ain't got really nothing to do, and you want to laugh and enjoy your food, go watch the homie, man. He's hella funny. Alright, so we decided, he hit me up for the collab, and I'm like, yo, I'm always down to work, and especially with the homie right there. So what was I gonna say? I have his video in the background getting ready to go pretty soon. We're gonna talk a little bit about him, and the collab that we're doing together is Chinese food. So we decided to do Panda Express, right? But we don't have a Panda Express out here up north in Ontario, Canada. So we did have something called PJ Panda. So I went by PJ Panda today, and they sold the business to Japanese and Korean fused, restaurant, and that looked fire. So I didn't want to mix it up, Trey. You know, I know we said we was going to do what we was going to do, so, but hey, that Korean food looked fire, so I'm going to have to do another mukbang on that. So I went here. I went to Yummy House. Alright, so this spot, it's just right up the street, and they got some pretty good food. There's another Chinese place right next to it where I usually get the wings that I like, but, you know, time was going, I said, you know what, let me just grab what I gotta grab and get out of here, and this is the new place right here, so, I don't know if y'all can see that. The Sushi, I think it says, yeah, The Sushi, The J Sushi, or The T Sushi, I don't know what that is. But anyway, hey, it's clean. It's they got hella stuff on the menu, so you have to like really go through and look. But they got the sushi. I'm gonna try the sushi. Man, they got a lot of stuff on here that looks bomb. So anyway, that's that. I'm gonna come with a mukbang for that. We're gonna talk about Trey a little bit and get into a little chit chat and just get ready to eat. So I'll show you guys what I got. So we eating on plates today. Fork. Actually, you know what? I like eating with plastic forks. I don't know why. To me, the food tastes better with plastic forks. Put the mic up for a second. The homie playing in the background. Okay. So I got a spring roll right here. I'll take everything out in a second. Alright. Ooh. It's nice. Ooh, it's hot. Nice and hot though. So what I got, I got all the sides, all the sauces and everything right here. I got the red sauce because I love to dip stuff in the red sauce. Go to lime right here. So we got, I'm gonna read y'all this fortune cookie and see what's popping. I've been getting a lot of good readings. I don't go for readings, I just stumbled across this lady that my homegirl introduced me to. And this lady has been 100% fire and on point. And I'll share a little bit of that with y'all. I'll share out her link if you guys are interested. Just want to get all this stuff here prepped real quick. Got a little hot sauce. I want to take it easy on the hot sauce because I got to get up in the morning. Ooh, I got two fortunes. Okay. Wait, hold on. Wait. I got three of them. Okay. And then the red sauce right here. Alright, so we'll set that right here. And to drink, we're gonna keep it hood. And we're gonna hit it with some orange Kool-Aid today. Alright, so let me plug up this mic. And we're gonna start eating. If you guys want some hella funny, cool ass little story times and skits, man, go check out the homie Trejo's World, man. He's 37 years old, out of Stockton, California, which is not too far from where I grew up in San Jose, California, Southside. Yeah, man, just California is a beautiful place, man. I miss home, but, you know, I'm making it out here in Canada, so I love it out here, too. Yeah, I got to come visit. So I'm looking forward to see what he got. So I just got something simple. I got, these people's food is hella bomb too. Oh, let's take the right, sorry y'all. Taking a little while, but we're gonna get to eating right now. I'm gonna do some smacking first before I start chit-chatting. But we got the shrimp fried rice. Let's see if we can get a thumbnail. I got some shrimp fried rice right here. I got a spring roll and I got some chicken wings. All right. So they go the thumbnail out the way. Put some rice. I did tell the homie that I was going to make that candy shrimp that I like. But I said, you know what, I'll just order it this time since I was, you know, trying to get out of there on time. But they didn't have it, so I was just like, how the hell you don't have the honey shrimp, the honey walnut shrimp? And they didn't have it, so I said, okay, it's cool, we'll just do it like this then. Just gonna do it like this. I'm going to give you a little story time about my little adventures in California and keep it a little hood today. I have a lot of hood stories, man, but, you know, I got certain type of viewers, man, that I just got to be careful. I shouldn't care, really, but, you know, it is what it is. I know my niece and them watch too sometimes, so I got to kind of, you know, keep it low key. So here you go, the chicken right here. I'm gonna save some of this for my lunch for tomorrow. All right, so let's get into this, you guys. All right, so man, again, thank you Trejo for working with your boy Snoopy Eats. And I'm excited to see what you got going on, your story time. That's gonna be dope. And I'm ready to grub, y'all. So let's hit this with some soy sauce. Right, and we'll just hit it with a pack of hot sauce. So what y'all, should I try the rice first? Let's try this rice first. Show I'm hungry. First bite, gang, because a lot of y'all out there, Snoop don't share his food. Yes, I do, my virtual world. I share my food. Yes, I do, Kristen B. I share my food, okay? Glow, all right? Big Hack, all y'all, all right? All y'all over there in the Big Hack Live. I share my food. Y'all got first bite. Mmm. Fried rice is bomb. Mmm. Sometimes I put ketchup on it. Mmm. Add some plum sauce for the spring roll. Look, you're getting two bites now. You're getting two bites, my virtual world. You're getting two bites, Kristen B. I don't want to hear shit. Don't be talking that smack. Mmm. fire though. Mm-hmm. Other than Filipino lumpias, Chinese spring rolls are way more tastier than the egg rolls, dog. Who agrees with me with that? Let's try the red sauce. Mmm. Mmm. There. You get three bites. You get tray bites for tray hope. What are you talking about? I don't share my food. Mmm. Their chicken wings, Chinese fried chicken wings, are bomb, y'all. You better ask somebody. Hella bomb. I'm gonna hit it with some lime. If I didn't have to work tomorrow, I would have killed it with some hot sauce, but we'll dip it in the, this red sauce right here. Alright. That's four bites. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've been actually dreaming about this, man. My Amazon Alexa. Very sensitive. I set the reminder. Remind me to get some Chinese fried chicken and red sauce just to eat. Not even necessarily to film, you know what I mean? Mmm. We grubbing today, y'all. Try this mustard. So, I'm gonna give you guys a quick little story time about my early 20s. Was it in my early 20s or late teens? I was like 19 or 20. Yeah, something like that. Okay, so me and the homies went jamming and partying and drinking and hanging out, chilling with some ladies and stuff, you know what I'm saying? Just, you know, we young, having fun, California, you know, all the homies out, fine ass girls, we're all just chilling, right? Drinking. And, some of the nights a bit fuzzy because that's when I used to smoke herb. But I do remember, you know, we're jamming out and there was a couple of strange cats that we didn't know, you know, from different neighborhoods or whatever. So anytime you see weirdos like that, you don't know, especially growing up in Cali, folks will approach you, you know what I'm saying? You get run up on. So some of that stuff is going on. We're drinking, having a good time, chopping up with the ladies or whatever. Coming toward the end of the night, we said, I'm gonna go have a session, right? I'm gonna go smoke, get blitz, get the munchies, eat, and then everybody, you know, do whatever they gotta do. Split up, go home or whatever. That's quality mustard, but I don't like it. I don't like the mustard on chia. So at this time, I grew up with this one brother named Tyrone, right? His family's just like my family. And his mom and my mom and their grandma were super tight. It's still tight. We just moved away, right? grandma and my mom used to do yard duty at my brothers and sisters' elementary school, and the young homies at some elementary school. And then later on, my mom and Tyrone's mama got really close. And they became really, really good friends. Because like back in the day, we used to go to church together. And then when we gave that up, we played ball. Started exploring. Living life as a young man. What to do, what not to do. You know, different neighborhoods. So basically my point is we grew up tight. You know, ride or dies. We used to call each other, say we were family, we were cousins, right? And most of the time, I'd be over at Tyrone's house anyway, lifting weights, kicking it. He'd be working on all his cars. He used to install car stereos, right? We would jack them and then install them. So back in my time coming up, old school heads will know this one. Back in my day coming up, the car stereos were called pullouts, right? Now, a pullout, if you ain't know what a pullout is, go Google it. That's classic retro right there. Pullout stereo, the whole stereo, once you hit the release button, would pull out. And it had a sleeve that came, that the stereo would come out, and then there was a steel sleeve inside, and if you took a screwdriver and peeled the flaps back like this, reached your hand in through a little hole, put your finger in the hole, right? So you finger the hole. Once you find the hole, you grip it like this, and you pull and yank, right? You try to get all the cord. That's how I knew how to do it. That's how these cats showed me how to do it, right? Just grab and pull and hope that you get a good pull and you don't destroy all the wires. Excuse me. And so we used to do that. That was how we used to, you know, get our little extra scratch on the side. And then they got hip to that after several years. They got hip to that, and they came with the detachable face, right? So now only the face comes off. Everything is stuck inside the car. So, I don't know why I'm going into that. I'm just reminiscing. So, my mom... Oh, yeah, it's because Tyrone taught me all that. That's why I got into that. So, we're young men boosted up on testosterone, kicking it, drinking, having a good time. Active, wilding out. So anyway, so my mom and Tyrone's mom started working together at a restaurant called Bob's Big Boy, right? So at around this time, you know, we used to go in there and eat and sit down and have dessert and chill. And the fams is there, right? Especially closing hours, you go in there and get something to eat. You know, we lit, keyed, got the munchies you want to eat, right? So at that function, like one night we went to Bobby Big Boy. This tall, light-skinned black dude, I don't know who the hell this dude is to this day. Used to see him around the neighborhood here and there, but never knew who he was, right? Apparently he was there where we were at. I wasn't paying attention. You know, we was chilling with Booty, so I didn't care about no dudes. So, we all pile up in our cars. We say, let's go see Moms and them. Get some food, because, you know, we got free stuff. We get to the spot. We go inside, we're chilling, we're eating. And I'm a dessert guy, so after my food, I wanted some of that ice cream. What was it, cake? I think it was like a cold cake or a pie or something like that. Chocolate with the cool whipped cream and all that stuff. Anyway, so we finished eating and we all head outside for a smoke, right? Off into the corner. And then moms and them, you know, they clean up. We get ready. It's closed. We're closed. So we just letting them vacuum and do their thing whilst we secure the perimeter. You know what I'm saying? The homies is outside, four or five of us, a couple of the homegirls, and we chilling. We smoking Newports, right? So tell me why Tall Cuz come up out of nowhere, right? This fool looked just like Gregory Hines. Why Gregory Hines come up out of nowhere trying to kick it with us? Hella faded, just talking hella shit, right? So we're like, yo, where does this dude follow us or whatever? So nobody's really paying attention too much. Like, we're faded. We don't even want to deal with him. So a couple of us started, you know, going to the cars or whatever, getting ready to leave. So now we're off to the corner where the cars are at. And this fool comes around the front, you know, the front exit, the front entrance where you come in and out of the restaurant, right? Bob's Big Boy. Right there in the heart of the South Side by Golfland, off Blossom Hill and whatever that street was right there. And dude started pissing. This dude whipped out his thing and started pissing on the wall, on the door, on the side of the door, and like right in front of the walkway, right? So we didn't see him doing this. We was off in the corner. And then I think it was both my mom and Tyrone's mom saw it and started yelling for me and Ty, right? So we run up over there and we see the dude standing there, like he acting like, you know what I'm saying, like trying to act cool and shit. He's hella drunk and he can barely stand up, right? So, okay, he had to go pee or whatever. This fool's so drunk and ignorant, this guy pissed right in front of the restaurant. So, whew, my mom was heated and so was Tyrone's mom, right? And they said, they were like, this fool disrespected and pissing in front, whipped out his thing, whoop to whoop and pissing in front of the restaurant. And y'all better take care of that. That's your friend. We said, yeah, our friend. Yeah, our homie or whatever. So now I'm pissed. Tyrone's lit. Tyrone is pit big. This brother's big too. Knockout artist too, right? Don't mess around with Tyrone, right? And me, I'm a little firecracker myself too. So I'm ready to take off on dude, right? So Ty had his own approach. Ty, he greedy when you want to knock somebody. He don't want you. He want to get all the glory, right? So they're like, yeah, get him out of here, whatever. And then the dude tried to get like a little attitude or whatever. So then Tyrone was like, hey, homie, step over here for a second like this. Ty must have took like two or three steps. I don't know what he said to dude in his ear or whatever. And he turned around and I swear, I put this on everything. It looked like that scene from Friday. When what's his name wanted to come, Ray wanted to get his bike back, remember? And he was like, what's up, homie? He goes, oh, man, Pop's tripping, man. You want me to come get my bike back? You know I wouldn't even trip. And then he goes, what bike? He goes, the Beach Cruiser, the one I let you last week. He goes, oh, that bike. Didn't know you wanted it back, homie. He's like, yeah, it's over here. Let's go get it, right? Turned around and did that big-ass uppercut. Well, that's exactly what the homeboy T-Bone did to this Gregory Hines-looking fool. Turned around after a couple steps of saying something to Cuz, right? And just lit on. Wow! Power just boloed this fool. Tyrone hit this fool. This fool, hey, the sound that made, hey, anyway, dude was like, whoop, stiff like this fool. This fool stiffened up like a dead bird and fell asleep in the air. And we just watched him hit his head hit the pavement, right? And that was the funniest shit. It was the most shocking shit. But I've seen Tyrone knock dudes out before, right? Like, we've gotten a lot of fights and I've seen Ty just put hands on niggas. But hey, the way he laid this dude out, man. And this was, I think this was before Friday even came out. But hey, anyway, he deboed this fool. He made sure that this fool did not, that he wasn't standing to catch another one. Ty was like, no, it's going to be a fatality. Just a finisher, a one-hitter quitter. That was Tyrone and my homeboy Junebug's thing. The one-hitter quitter. Let's see if we can knock somebody out with the one-hitter quitter. And let me tell you, boy, Tyrone, that boy, he can knock you out with one hitter quitters. He was a big boy, but he was strong. Ty was strong, man. He was strong. I'm getting fat. I didn't even eat my chicken. But yeah. So he hit dude. That dude fell. Busted shit up. You know. Then Mountain Dew came out. They were tripping because they didn't want no, like, they didn't want it to go to that extent. They just wanted us to, like, you know, just check him or whatever. You know, maybe choke him out or something. But you can't tell three or four homies that are already on the street active to take care of a situation peacefully. It's not happening. That fool got destroyed. Cuz went into a straight deep sleep in midair and then hit the ground. His face busted all up on the sidewalk. So tell me why. I don't remember how long after I quit Oak Grove High School and was going to a vocational school called CCOC off of Capitol, right? So shout out to my folks over there that went to CCOC for vocational, a couple of homies. And tell me why I see dude a couple seats down from me talking about, yo, hey man, hey homie. He sounded just like Ray Friday. What happened that night? What happened? I think he knew very well what happened. He got knocked the fuck out, right? So, hey, homie, you got knocked out, cuz you, hey. But I didn't tell him that. I told him, I said, oh, man. I said, hey, look, you was, I said, cuz you was hella faded, though. I said, you was faded, fool. And, like, we was all, you know, getting ready to leave or whatever. And you tried to take off, too. And you slipped, dog, and you twisted your ankle and you fell, bust your face on the street. That's what I told him. I said, you bust your face. I said, you slipped and fell, cuz. We ain't ratting none of the homies out. And I'm not trying to hold no conversation with this fool before I start chucking him with him. He was like, I think I was hit. I think I got hit. And I'm dying in my head. I'm like, yeah, fool. You got hit hard enough for four dudes. God, knock the fuck out, Craig. God damn. Oh, man. God damn. That run, though, that Smokey did, though, when Red got knocked out. Classic movie. But, yeah, man, I got some funny hood tales, man. I think I told this on a story time a long, long time ago when I was still a little camera shy about the time we went to the Rich Hills where all the white girls was at, right? We was trying to find it that night, right? And we found it, and they invited us back. It was the homeboys linked us link up, right? So, anyway, we went there, and a whole episode of crazy, funny shit went down where I got locked into a bathroom, and the homies took off and were in the cars. I thought I was done for it. So if you guys want to hear that story time, just leave me a comment as a reminder because I'll be forgetting. Leave me a comment, say, hey, Snoop, I want to hear that story time when you got stuck at the girl's house. And then I'll come back with another story time, but I don't want to keep you guys any more longer. So Trajo, that's the homie right there, man, from the West Coast. Y'all please go check out his channel, subscribe to him, show him some love, smash that like for him, leave him a comment. When you leave in the comments, tell me you coming over from Snoopy's gang. Alright, the homies, Snoopy's gang, the homegirls, Snoopy's angels. Hit his notification bell. If you love that brother's content, man, show him some genuine love. Because, hey, this guy's been down with me for, we don't talk that much. But I want to say going on 2 years now. And it's only now that we're getting to work together. So, anyway, I got much love and respect for this cat. He's a cool dude. And I think you'll like him too. So, with that being said, check out the homie Trejo. Alright. And until the next one, keep it crispy. I love you guys. Stay blessed. You know what I'm saying? Stay away from negativity. There's a lot of busters running around out here. You know what I'm saying? Just bad acting and playing victim. But listen, y'all already know what to do. You know what I'm saying? We stay riding. Real riders. You feel me? And shout out to my whole camp and my whole crew, man. Shout out to Big Heck, to everybody, all the homegirls, man. From Glow to Amy to Abby to everybody who shows me love, man. Shout out to Lucia again. What? Yo, Lucia did me proper with a shout out, man. You know, like a little video thing she did for the homies. So I appreciate you very much. I appreciate all y'all, man. I love that love, and I'm going to continue showing love. Can't stop, won't stop. You know what I'm talking about? All right? So it's your boy Snoop Eats. I'm signing out. I love y'all. Bless you. So tell me why I forgot to do this. All right? So let's see. Got three of them. Let's see what we got here. Open that one. Open that one. What's my fortune? What's this right here? Okay, so this one says, you're a dreamer and your thinking is inspirational, which is dope because I be dreaming and astral traveling and all that good shit. Shout out to Roxy, you know, for mentioning that in one of her videos where she was talking about, you know, sleep paralysis. You know, having sex with ghosts. Get ready to do something daring. They got all these numbers here. I should play them too. Get ready to do something daring. Okay. Well, shit, I do have some stuff lined up. I do have some stuff lined up now. A good reputation is more valuable than money. I guess. But I like those first two. That's pretty dope. But like I said, the lady that I'm going to link down below, if you guys are interested, just give it a shot. You know what I'm saying? Just give it a shot. Listen, this lady's off the hook and she's very accurate. You go over there, man. Tell her I sent you too. Tell her I sent you. I was actually in her live, the last 30 minutes of her live earlier today. And she's an amazing lady, man. So go check her out. And That's it. That's it, folks. You're probably not going to hear from me for another 3 or 4 days. But I will be on the gram. I will be on Twitter. I will be on Snapchat. I will be on Facebook. But I hate Facebook. Love Instagram. I'm always on there. All right. So anyway, you guys be safe. Again, peace out. All right. Love y'all.